plan our month. Every week, pick a day. Hopefully you all have at least one day off a week. Pick a day and do your fortune 14. Fortune 14. And what you'll do is you'll figure out who you're talking to. And I say 14 because ultimately if you do 7 days a week of exposures, that would actually be better. If possible, figure out who you're talking to. Two a day, two a day, two a day, two a day, two a day for 7 days. That's your fortune 14. And I should have brought my planner. But what I do is I open it to the week. And on Sunday, I'll put two names down. On Monday, I'll put two names down. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, whatever. I'll put the two names. So when I open my planner, I'm like, okay, I got to talk to these two today. Okay, go. And some days I'm like, I'm going to skip them and do it next week, right? Because we get nervous. If you, though, know that you don't have any two people to talk to, then you might say, I'm going to Target because I need to talk to people. You need to figure out who you're talking to and make it a choice. And then also put your follow-ups in there so you don't forget to follow up with people. So, fortune 14, figure out before the week begins who you're talking to and make it more intentional. If you know who you're talking to, this business can happen like this. It'll be done. You'll have your activity done for the day very quickly. If you've been in this 5 years and you're like, well, I've officially run out of people to talk to, I'm going to say, nope, you haven't, because we always make new friends. We always friend new people on Facebook. If you go to your Facebook friend list and you look at every single name, I guarantee there's someone you have missed that you think you've talked to. I had a girl I went to high school with sign up as a brand partner in Indiana. She was like, I have a new brand partner with Nerium. And I messaged my friend. I go, please tell me she signed up with you. And she goes, nope. And I go, oh, crap. We missed one. I grew up in a town of 1,200 people, and we missed one. She signed up with a different team, you guys. And she's like, I love this stuff. And I was like, I hate myself because I missed one. Not, I don't care if you signed up with someone else, but she's my people. I want to work with her. And so we still helped her, and we still work together, but make sure you don't miss that one. I had a nightmare 2 months ago that someone gave my best friend EHT. She's never done the business. She's not even a customer. But I have never given her EHT, and she coaches cross-country. She's big into working out. And I woke up in a panic. I'm like, somebody else gave her product, you guys. I know that's not a normal dream. But I called her, and I was like, oh, my gosh, I just had a dream. Someone else gave you product. And she was like, calm down. Just send it to me. So the point being, there I was at a, I don't even know where I was. I was at an event for networking. It had nothing to do with Nerium. And these two six-figure earners were on stage, and they were best friends. They were not on the same team because that one best friend forgot to tell the other best friend what he was doing. Signed up under someone else. God, you don't want that to happen. In the next 3 to 5 years, everyone will know what Nerium is. Please open your mouth so people at least know you do it. I have been prospected by 4 companies this week. You know what that made me do? Put more Nerium on my page, because obviously they're delusional if they think that I'm looking at something else. I really like your profile. You'd be awesome at what I do. I'm like, well, you're darling, but I'm doing fine. Okay? I love Nerium. Leave me alone. So when you're sharing and when you're being open, don't forget, we don't need to blast Facebook. Do real life posts. Watch other leaders in the room if you're not sure how much to post Nerium. But every once in a while, put it out there because people will forget you do it. Even though we feel like we're very present, they'll forget you do it if you don't have it pop up every so often. And on Saturdays, I get a lot of people asking to be customers when I do a post about products. So definitely have that out there. Share the products. Figure out that you can get bottles in people's hands. The iCRM is, it's opening a whole new level of this business. Especially the eye patches as well, where you can put them on someone within a few minutes. And there are slides I'm going to do that on here. But to send it to someone, I just had a girl who, she's one of the ones I chased away with my golden retriever approach. And, whoops, I was in my first few months. She was literally signing up to be a brand partner. Like, on the computer. And she panicked. And then she went into the witness protection program, and I haven't heard from her. So she commented on Instagram and said, I need to try those patches. And I was like, I'm sending her some for free because I guarantee I scared her off. So I sent her a set of them, and I said, try them and take pictures. Because I thought, okay, I at least know her that much. So she's going to try the eye serum and eye patches, take pictures, and put it on social media for me. Your friends will do that for you. My lip sense friends who do the lipstick, I'll put it on and I'll take pictures and put it on social media for them if it helps them. So just don't forget to share the products. Keep things moving. Attend weekly market party or real results party. Where do you all have market parties at? You can say about it. Okay, perfect. We do about one a month where we do it in public, and then we will do Zoom ones as well. What I will say is if you live in an area, some of you drive from really far away to be here. Like, how many of you drove 3 hours or more? Yes. Give them a big hand. And some of your little sweet friends are at their house 10 minutes away, and you're like, right? What I do. All right. If you drove that far, you're committed. You can just like close your eyes. You don't even have to see this part. But if you don't have an event, have an RRP. Even if you're nervous, even if nobody shows up, do it anyway. You never know. You never know. I'll give you my little tip for this. Well, actually, we'll talk about it later. I want to keep moving. But there are ways to almost guarantee that you'll have people show up to your RRP. Your first number one thing, though, is mindset. You have to assume they're coming. Just throwing that out there. Attend weekly training. That's your Nerium University. Again, do it on Zoom. If you're not near a group that gets together, meet with your team, watch it together on Zoom. Having Zoom and other technologies is opening a whole new world for all of us because we're all so busy. My son's 11, and he goes, you know, I feel like Zoom could really help you grow your business, Mom. I was like, thanks. Appreciate your advice. And he's like, I just really see the benefits. I'm like, okay. If you want to sign up pretty soon, that'd be great. Attend monthly regionals. You all are here. One thing I would suggest, and I'm not trying to be snotty, so don't take it like that, but take tons of pictures today. Act like you're having a ball, even if you're like, eh, it's okay. Act like you're having fun. Take pictures with your Easter eggs, the cupcakes, like, take some pictures and put them on social media. People do not sign up for another job. They sign up to have somewhere fun to go that they can belong and make some money. If you make this look like a meeting or a visitation, for heaven's sakes, no one's going to come. I know, I couldn't think of anything else, but no one's going to show up. But if you post pictures on social media and you're like, regionals is amazing. Oh my gosh, look at these cupcakes. This is so fun. People will come because they'll be like, well, I'm going to do something. I have a girl, she's a former student, and she works in our grocery store, and I was checking out yesterday, and she said, would you go on vacation next, Mrs. Stevens? I've unfortunately, or fortunately, branded myself as someone who never stays home, and I said, oh, we leave tonight for Kansas City. She goes, gosh, I need to figure out what you do. And I was like, we should probably chat. I think we could talk about it. But you guys, have fun on social media. People notice. They notice. Guess what? No one needs you to be a certain way. I used to be so nervous to post on social media because I thought, what are people going to say? You guys, they're going to talk about you either way. Not necessarily mean, but they're going to be like, oh, they're in one of those companies. Give them something to talk about at least. Be like, yeah, you like my new car? Boom. Give them something to talk about. So when you post on social media, have fun. You saw my post yesterday. I had eye patches on, my sunglasses, and I was like, I don't care. Have fun. You only get one chance to live, and I'm pretty sure you want to have a pretty good story to tell. So have fun with that. Attend all major, and I'm not saying like we want them to feel left out, but we do a little. Okay, just saying. All right, attend all major corporate conventions. Who's going to St. Louis? You guys, if you don't go to St. Louis, you're insane. You live like a minute away. You're insane. Figure out how to get there. If you have to call in sick and shut down your social media for the weekend so no one tags you in anything, go. I can say it here because none of you really know me. When I was teaching, you get no vacations. You have to be there all day long because they need the teacher. And I would start my cough at about Thursday. I'd be like, ugh, oh man, my throat. Or like Wednesday. And then on Fridays, I'd be like, oh man, I think I have a temperature. And I would go home early, and I would start driving to Chicago to go to their regionals, because we didn't have any regionals. And I'd be like, man, I feel sick. And I was like, if you guys tag me in anything, you're dead. I was sick yesterday. So I never have pictures of those regionals, because I faked it. Because I But they only let you use 5 for your family for the entire year. So you're out of those, like, instantly, because my kids are never sick at the same time. And I had, like, 79 sick days. And so when I knew it was my last year teaching, I was like, I gotta go. And I would go to as much of this as I could. Just saying. Don't say I told you to. But if you can block your social media and get your butt to these conventions, I promise you, the person who goes and the person who leaves will not be the same person. You will leave the, I don't know, I had bad descriptors and they weren't going to sound nice. I stopped myself. See, my filter is working. You will leave the fear and doubt and scared person there. You'll leave it there. Because when you can plug in to 20, 30, 40,000 other people who know that Nerium is their ticket, you're good. And then you're going to come here every month to make sure you keep refilling that, but you're good. So figure out how you're going to get there. I would be like bawling if none of you came because it is so close to you all. So just like Iowa, the Iowa team, I'm like, you all have no excuse. Like, you can get there. So let's get the Midwest to show up to St. Louis. Let's do it. The things Nerium has coming are insane. Commit to personal development. How many of you honestly say you do personal development every day? Good. It's more than I thought. Personal development can be whatever it needs to be for you. It can be a church sermon that you watch. It can be quotes that you read and think about. It can be books. I have major ADD, not diagnosed, I just know I do. I have to listen to the audibles because I have to be doing other things. I actually, a lot of times, will do audible, and then I'll be typing on my phone different notes that I hear of things that I want to use later. So figure out how you learn best. If you are not a reader, download the Audible app. There is a yearly fee, but you also get so many credits free, so you can download books for free. It's awesome. And then if you like to walk or do other movement, do it. It will be the one thing that changes you faster than anything else can in this business. My kids even start to read personal development now. It's pretty awesome. Find a workout partner. Do you all have those? Do you all have your people you plug into or not really yet? Yeah, some new. Okay, perfect. So I'm bad at this. I like to work with lots of different people. I don't have that one person because we all have very strong personalities, depending on what it is. We're all really good at some things, right? Find someone who's good at something different than you are so that they can help fill that for you. My best friend is amazing at building belief in people, but she is horrible at details. I'm not kidding. She wouldn't know how to qualify for NLC if she had to write it on a piece of paper. No, like, I love her, but she is not a detailed person. I have the details, so we work together. And she'll be like, I can't do this part. You need to help me. And I'll do it, and I'll say, I need you to do a call for my team and make them cry. She's like, I got you. Right? Like, that's just how she is. So find people that fill those voids that you have. It's so fun to work with like-minded people, but find someone who's a little different, too. And then be here in a year and be NLC qualified, and I think we'll recognize the NLC people during recognition. Maybe. I just keep clicking. You guys have to almost do it on here. Coach the sport for the love. Reach out to those people. You already have that coach. 14, who you're going to talk to each day. Have some chocolate while you sit here so you get your energy back up. Figure out when you're hosting an RRP. The other thing I'll talk about really quick is a PCC. Who knows what a PCC is? You're awesome. Thank you. PCC, it stands for Personal Conference Call. How many of you have done a PCC? Oh, there's a few of you. Okay, yell out to me what you liked best about doing a PCC. Mike, what would you guys like best about it?
Invited you on the call.
they say, I'm brand new, I don't have a lot of the information, so I want so-and-so to help you. And then you mute your phone and you just let us run with it. It's the easiest way for us to help you other than an RFP. Yeah.
Can I share something real quick with
everybody? Yeah.
And so she had like five people on the PCC, and she had about, I think, four of them on the market party. So that worked really well. So just to let you guys know, you want to do a PCC, do it right before a market party, and we can, the expert will lead them to the market party for you.
And that is why you guys are leaders in the market. That's awesome. That's perfect. Let us do the work. That's what we're here for. We can answer questions, and if people say crazy stuff, we've heard it, so we can help you. So don't panic about what goes down, and then once the call's over, don't worry. Don't be like, well, now what do I do? See what they like best. Some of them will be like, I need that product. Or if the call's over and you know that you don't hear a lot, like they're not really texting you, send out some before and after pictures to those people and say, here's what some of the products do. Because if you send my friend's stomach to people, they're going to be like, I need that, because it is about that time of year, people. We're about to be in public swimming pool season. So you definitely want the Nerium firm if you don't have it. Okay, so I know that was kind of off, but it was a good time to do it because things were down. So talk to your leader, schedule before you go if you can, because once it's in your book, you have to do it. So do it. I have a girl on my team. She's been in the business about 2 years. She just hit senior brand partner last night. She's 24. Has not had an easy time with things, not Nerium, but just life. And I got a text this month and she was like, I'm doing this. And I was like, okay. I had, I think, 6 text messages from her earlier this week of when she needed PCCs with each person on her team. Like, she's leading them to do PCCs. Because they're not going to do it on their own. So if you have a team, lead them to do those PCCs, fill up their calendars. I know they are like, I love nothing more than a booked up calendar, especially when it all can be done from my house. It's easy to do. So it's so easy to do. It's 15 minutes. People can listen while they're driving home. They can listen while they're making dinner, whatever works. But remember, April is about stepping out of our comfort zone. One thing I can tell you is when Nerium says we are about to blow your minds, they're really about to blow your minds. Fill up your funnel now. April 1st, you're home. You're fine. I don't care. April 1st to May 1st is fill that funnel. I was going to say like it's your job, but it is your job. So fill it. And then May, we get health and wellness products, and you've got a huge amount of people you can tell. Or they're wildly excited for those products to come out, and they're ready to go. We have a couple former college football players that have seen it, they're excited about EHG, and they're dying for these health and wellness products to come out. He's like, I can't wait for that. I'm like, I know. So we keep dripping on them to keep them excited and inviting them to events. So fill the funnel now. Get lots of people who at least know you do Nerium so that when the health and wellness products drop, you have people you can reach out to. That's our goal. I want everyone to cut your ties with the outcome starting today. Quit worrying about what's going to happen. Just do it and wait and see. Do your RRP without worrying about if people are going to sign up as brand partners. Do market parties and invite people without worrying about what's going to happen. Do your exposures without worrying about what's going to happen. You cannot control that because you're dealing with live human beings, and we never know what people are going to do. So you have no control over human nature, so let it go. I have this on. It's going to rattle the microphone. I won't pull it out. I have a necklace on. It's one of those giving keys. Have you seen those? It's down my dress, so you're not going to, but it says, let go on it. Because we have to let go of things we cannot control. If you can let go and start having fun with this, you will come in May and be like, let's go. And this room will be full because you're having fun. Because nobody's worried about what happened. It's over. Move on. So we're going to have fun. It goes along with this, I swear. But let go to the things that you cannot control and just do the activity. And just do it happen. crazy happens or someone nuts, be like, huh, that's fascinating. That's what we say on our team. When someone's a complete nut or you get a really random response or really rude, I'm always like, fascinating. And then I just walk away because I'm like, I'm not married to them. They don't live at my house. Thank God. Right? So we do what we do. Commitment is doing the thing you said you would do long after the mood has passed. You are in the mood today to do it. You have to be committed. Put it in your planner before you go so that you follow through. My April is almost booked up. I have a three-way call that I scheduled for today, for this evening, for myself, because I know that my team's watching. And so I'm doing it on April 1st because I also would like them to work on April 1st. So figure out what we can do today that will bleed into the rest of your week and launch and grow. All right, so building your list. I don't care how long you've been in the business. You have told me that no one in here is new. Can you print this off at the beginning of every month and do it for yourself? Yes. I still print this off because I love it. It keeps me so organized for the month to figure out who I need to talk to, have they had product, a video, a sit-down, a three-way call, where are they at? And then your people who have already purchased, you can just like write PC next to their name so you know they're good. If they haven't, then at the end of the month when you're doing that frantic follow-up of help, I need NLC points or whatever, you have a list of people to work from and you remember what you said to them. Todd Cahill and Anna Camp have their Fort Knox in a box, if you've heard them talk. I can't keep that straight. That does not work for me. I think it's awesome it works for them. My point is this may not work for some of you. Figure out a system that works for you to keep your prospects straight. And life will be so much easier. So many of us try and keep it up here. And no amount of EHT is going to make that work for us, okay? Because in, 6 months, you're going to be like, crap, I forgot to follow up with that salon owner. Dang it. Write it down somewhere. I keep mine in my planner because it's zipped shut, so I won't lose it. So, rebuild your list. This can just be found in your back office under resources. You can look up Fast Start Game Plan, and you can just print it out from there. So, this is also excellent when you all have your new starts this month, because you're all going to have a ton, right? Yeah, you have to say it like you believe it. You're all going to have new starts this month, and when you go help them get started, you will want to print this list and bring it with you. Because if you say, okay, so you're going to go home and print it out, guess what? They're probably not going to. But if you bring a list and you work on it with them in person, you're that much further ahead. So when you have a new start, print this out and bring it with you. Or if you're doing it over Zoom, figure out a way to email them the link, and you've got leaders that can help you do that. So build your list. Do this every month. Help your team do the same. If you meet with Nerium University in person and you do that on Mondays, have everyone do this to plan your month. We really have to be intentional in April, you guys. Really, really, really. We need all ducks in a row for when these new products come out. Because I think it's going to, I don't know, but I think it's going to be fast and furious when they do, and so we need to be ready. And if you're, the more organized, the better. Okay, so this is how you sort your list. Most of you have seen this. RRP, product, video, or sit down. Oh, the other thing I want to say is figure out from those four what you're good at. And any of us can do any of them, but you have a sweet spot in those of things that you're most comfortable. I have a girl on my team who's literally the nicest person. She lives in Florida, and she keeps trying to do three-way calls and lead from a script, like a business person. And I'm like, okay, sweetie, like you are way too caring and loving to use a script. People know that's not you. If my husband used a script, people would be like, yep, that's what he talks like. He's very smart, but when he's in business, that homie doesn't. But when he's in business, it's like a script. He's just very business-like. This girl is so sweet and loving, and I said, you should be doing sit-downs and just talk to people because that's what you're good at. She's like, no, I think you're right. I feel like I am. I said, if I'm wrong, prove it by doing a bunch of sit-downs. We'll see what happens. I'm willing to take that risk. But I said, figure out what you're good at and run with it. I loved RRPs because I love having people over. And I don't, like, make my house cute or anything. Like, we just drink wine and eat chips and whatever. Like, we just have fun. But that worked for my area. Three-way calls are also a sweet spot for me. I love getting people on three-way calls and introducing them to my friends who are in the business. So figure out what you're good at. Try everything because your prospects aren't always going to go along with everything. Some prospects like parties better, so you really still need to try everything, but figure out what you can rock and feel awesome about. If you can rock sit-downs, make that your sweet spot. Buy yourself a Starbucks card because you're going to need it. All right, so how we acquire customers, most of you know this. If you have always just kind of known this, really laser focus this month, like I said, before we add new products. Because you're all going to have so many new people to train, you're going to need to know this stuff. All right, so share it. We let people try it. Day and night cream, eye serum. One thing I've noticed, and I know some of you have heard this, well, I stole from Raylan when you all did your bottles out, Operation Bottles Out. I was like, we need to do that because our team needed energy. We needed that, like, come on, you guys. So I said, Raylan, I'm stealing your idea. She's like, okay, no problem. We did Operation Bottles Out, and we had over 100 and maybe 100 bottles out within like a week. That's pretty reasonable to pull from. And then if you all just follow up, it works out. So if you haven't done that in a while, do it again. I know you're like, yeah, but I already posted it. People are weird. They're not always going to comment, even if they really want it. It usually takes them a couple times. So do it again. Do the eye serum. When I sample out both the day and night cream, I tend to get customers for both the day and night cream. Weird, right? Because they don't understand how good the day cream is. Unless you let them try it. Or if you've got a lot of influence and you can just say you also need the day cream because you just need it. They'll maybe listen to you. But if you have friends that are skeptical, they may need to sample the day cream. So use your Nerium gifts back, get some day cream in your house because it will help your volume if they're buying two products. And then, okay, so share it and then sell it. You can sell retail. Retail is like a dirty word. One thing you can do though is my mom lives in a new townhome. Her neighbor is obsessed with Nerium. I get messages all the time. Now tell me about this EHT. Like she wants a new product every week. She's so cute. And I said, okay, just leave me a check. I'll bring you a product. And we just do it like that. And then I go in and add it to her ADO and then I have it shipped to me. You all know you can do that. If you don't know that, talk to someone who's sitting next to you later and we'll help you with that. But if you've got product on hand that you can sell, then you go in and still enter them as a customer, but you have the first shipment come back to you so that you get your product back. They get theirs in person. Some people want it right now. Her neighbor really wants it right now. Like I get messages all the time. So ideal product, all of them. Perfect. So there's lots of ways to do this. Make sure you know the ins and outs. I know most of you are like, yeah, we know. Perfect. Then let's wrap it. If you already know, let's go. So how? There's a quote, if you look up even business quotes anywhere, it says, give someone an experience, not a product. We're giving them an experience. We're saying, try this for 5 days. I cannot wait to hear how your skin feels. How your skin feels. Because are they going to look like they had a facelift in a week? Most are not. Make sure we set really basic expectations. Make sure they add water for the love. And just say, I can't wait to hear how your skin feels. You're going to love it. Most people just need you to tell them they're going to love it, and they'll love it. When you're nervous, you're like, oh, I hope it goes okay. Please, God, don't break out. They're going to break out. Like, you have to have a good mindset with this. I had a friend. Actually, she's probably going to start the business with me. She was a cold market at a vendor show that I went to kicking and screaming because I did not want to go. And I was like, okay, you're just going to meet people. Ready, go. And I was like, hey, oh my gosh, you're so cute. And I just talked to people and I friended them on Facebook. It's like a fairy wand, just like that. It was magic. If you can do that every time, oh man, I'll just point. Okay. That was awesome. Okay, anyway, so I just met a bunch of people. I followed up with her and I said, hey, I know that you were looking at product. We have a new eye patch. Can I send it to you to try? Because she's on social media and has a million followers. And she goes, actually, I really need something for my eyes. And I said, well, I don't want to type you a message. Can I call you? Talk to her. She ordered product on the spot. I messaged her 3 days later, and she goes, I am loving this stuff. And I said, hey, are you using water? She goes, what do you mean? well, there's no water in the product, which is awesome because then we're not selling water, but you have to wet your face down to activate the product. She's like, seriously? And I said, you're loving it without water? She goes, yes. I'm like, weird. I'm like, you're really going to love it when you use it right. So follow up. Even if they love it, make sure they're using it correctly because they're probably not going to get results if their face isn't wet, okay? So double check. She still loves the product, and she was spending up to $2,000 to $5,000 a year on skincare before Nerium. So don't be afraid. Even if it's someone, they're like, well, I only buy this. Well, try this. Tell me how it compares. You guys did not invent the Nerium products. If they tell you no, it doesn't matter. You didn't invent it. If you invented it, you're allowed to have hurt feelings. But you did it. So I was like, I don't know. I didn't invent it. You cannot be emotionally tied to that little bottle, okay? Let it work. Do the best you can do, but have a great mindset about it. So this is something you can print from your back office to hand out with your day and night cream bottles. In this day and age, I also will say, what's your phone number? So I can text you a video of how to use the product. So if any of you send bottles out of town, put a sticky note on it that says, text me when you get this so I can send you a video of how to use it. Good guess what? We don't like start calling them and being obnoxious, but at least you have their phone number. So you text them a video of how to use it. You've got their number. So many people are visual. They will throw those directions away. And they're like, I don't know why it's not working. Well, did you open the box? Have you tried it? So definitely do your part. There's still going to be those outliers that do random things with your product. But if you can set the expectations and give them directions of all things, you can make that happen. And then explain the sampling process. Obviously, when it says encourage through you are free, I find, and maybe it's different in your market, I find that many people are reluctant to get their product free, which is very strange. Maybe it's not for you guys here, but in Iowa, people are like, oh no, I can't do that. Like, why? So I usually say, well, if you want to keep it a secret, you can pay full price. If you want me to help you, we can help you get it free. Here's where you use a three-way call. We were taught when we started, always make sure they were interested in the business before you did a three-way call. But what I want to remind you of is I was not interested in the business. I just wanted the stupid product. And she put me on a call to hear about the science because she knows I care. Put me on a call, tells me how to get it free, and I was like, well, I'm going to get my product free. That's a no-brainer. And then she says you could also get paid on that product. And I went, because no, she didn't know that I was desperately searching for something, but I did not know it would come in the form of skincare or this industry. I was online every day looking at other degrees I could get, you guys, and my husband's like, please, no, no more school. Because I just was so burned out. And I don't always say that in my market because it's a lot of my former students' parents, and I don't want them to be like, oh my gosh, she hated her kids. No, no. Just very tired after teaching that many years. But, and one thing I want to say, this may not be the right place to do it, but do a three-way call and just say, I want to tell you how you can get your product free and a few of your other options. How you can get your product free and a few other options. When would you have a few minutes to chat? And ideally, you would say, when do you have a few minutes to chat? Tonight. You give them a time frame, because otherwise they'll ignore you. But just, I want to help, I want to make sure you know how to get your product free and a few other options. And then, you can put them on a three-way call with Raylan or whoever else, and she can say, oh my gosh, you can get it free. Also, you can do this, because you've already teed it up as you're going to hear all your options, so then they can't panic if they hear the word business. Because we believe in Nerium, you should know your options so you can do what's best for you. No one's going to get mad at you for that. It's your job, it's your business to let people know. Just like when you go to different businesses and they say, do you know about our return policy? And you have to like initial that you heard them. You're just doing your job. So do a three-way call because you don't know how many people have not told you they're dying for something. And then they sign up. I went to Starbucks to use eye serum on a friend. She's like, I want to try it. And I put it on her, and she leaned in and goes, how did you retire from teaching? And I was like, oh, I did not see the sit-down going here. And I said, well, and I opened up the Success magazine, showed her some stuff, and I said, you know what? I want you to meet my friend Tanya, who talked to me about the business. You're my friend. I don't want to sit and give you a commercial. I just want you to hear Tanya's story and then we can chat. And I put her on a 3-way call. But you just don't know. So be really open to see what's going to happen. All right, so sell the product. Contact your list, use third-party tools. You all know this stuff. Promote our customer programs. The customer loyalty program's amazing. People are saving money. It does keep them in longer. Place orders and then ask for referrals. So usually if someone loves the product, I say, well, if there's anyone you know of that would like to sample, send me their info and I'll send them some product to try. I've gotten several customers from customers. And then you just say, if they want to order them under you so that you can get closer to earning your product for free. If I broke it again, he's going to shoot me. Okay, Nerium's loyalty program. And one thing I'm going to say, you guys, is with the new products coming out, you're going to have even better customer retention. Because if you get that one person who uses one drop of night cream and they have way too much, and say, well, have you tried any of our wellness products? They're going to find something they can throw in the mix. So it's going to help even more. So month one, month two, month three, and month four. And I always say, to be premier, you have to have an order go through every other. So I have a girl in Florida, and she'll message me like the 30th of every month and say, okay, next month I want this. And I go in and just help manage her order. Okay, next month I want this. And I said, have you tried EHT? I'm like, it helps with memory. Maybe sometimes helps if you take it before you go out for the night. I don't know if you've tried that. But she was like, yeah, I need that one. Like, okay, perfect. So offer people products to help keep them in. You can't assume that they'll want the same one forever. Okay, brand partner acquisition. I really don't like this slide. I don't feel like I'm in a business of acquiring people. Do you? I don't really. So I like to think of it as more building your team. I don't know. I feel weird about that. I'm going to acquire some brand partners today. Oh, don't talk like that. You will not have a team. Okay, so the first one is be excited. You guys, when I signed up for Nerium, I never even tried the product. We could have been selling toothpaste and I would have been in because I hated my job. I was wildly unhappy. I knew that my friend would help me, and the girl I talked to on the phone had had major success. And no one in my area knew what Nerium was, so in my mind it was a no-brainer. We literally could have sold toothbrushes and toothpaste, and I would have been like, let's do this. Have excitement, no matter what. Even if it's a little fake until you are pumped up, have excitement. And if you are not personally excited, hold on to the people that are. I've seen your leaders. I've seen the videos they post. I've seen how wildly excited they are about this business and this company. If you are not, be like, well, they are, so it's probably awesome. Okay, hold on to that. When I was newer in the business, I had no confidence in myself. This would have never happened. No confidence. But my leaders kept saying, you've got what it takes. You will absolutely be an NMG. And I was like, I mean, she said so, so I hope. And I just did what they said, but I leaned on their belief and their confidence in me to help you be excited. If you do 3-way calls, if you do RRPs, and if you do PCCs, your leaders will edify you to your friends and family, meaning they will talk about how amazing you are as a person, how amazing you are in the business, and they would be lucky to partner up with you. That's a big deal for your friends and family to hear. Plus, you know who else needs to hear it? You do. Do the activity as well, so your friends and family see you as something different than just your neighbor, your mom, your whoever. So that will help your excitement, is my point. Invite 4 times the amount of people. It's just like a wedding. And if it rains, who knows how many people will come. Jeff Olson says that in his success CD, that if it rains at your funeral, like 1 in 10 people will come. You guys, if they're not coming to your funeral, who cares what they think? Who cares if they're like, oh, you're in one of those companies? You're not even coming to my funeral. I don't even care about you. Right? Like, who cares? So, I mean, don't say that to them because then you're not getting a customer. But in your head, be like, whatever, you're not even coming to my funeral. I thought about that. You know when you see, like, funeral processionals? In our family, because of my dad passing away, we kind of have a sick sense of humor about it now. But we'll see, like, a funeral procession, and I'll be like, well, it's raining. No one's going. People are shallow. So, number one, do not get emotionally hurt if they don't come to your RRP because you know they're probably not coming to your funeral. So do the You can't let their lack of effort hold you back in your business. You got to go without them. And it says talk, don't test. I want to give you a couple little pointers on this. Depending on the generation you're in, depends on how to handle it. So if you are, and I'm 100% stereotyping this, so just roll with me. If you're in your 50s and 60s, you are going to want to pick up the phone and call them to invite them. 100%. Don't text them. They don't want to read your message. Pick up the phone and call. Maybe FaceTime, depending if they're used to it. But generally, you want to pick up the phone and call them. If they're in their 30s and 40s, you're going to want to text them and say, hey, when are you free so I can call you? Because we have to get mentally prepared for a phone call. I do. Maybe some of y'all are like, yeah, I love to talk. Like, someone will call, and I'm like, why are they calling me? My neighbor called, and I was like, is everybody okay? She's like, yeah. I was like, why are you calling me then? I thought it was an emergency. So, maybe, I know it's dumb, you guys, but you have to think about the person you're contacting and figure out what are they going to be all right with. If you don't know, just pick one. You cannot screw this up. When my friend prospected me, she sent me the history of the company in a Facebook message. I still have it. Literally, the entire story of Nerium in a Facebook message. And I was like, that's a little much. And I still got on the dumb call. And I still signed up without trying product. If it's the right person, you can't screw it up, so take pressure off yourself, but try not to screw it up. So you're going to call certain people. If they're in their, I'm going to say 20s and 30s, text them, send a Facebook message. Learn how to use Instagram if you can, because it really is the future of social media. Snapchat, some of you are like, oh, Lord. Figure out what you can do. People, you guys, my prospects who are in their 20s, respond on Snapchat within minutes. They get back to me. How many of you are like in your 20s? There's a couple of you who, I mean, everyone was young, but do people respond on Snapchat quicker than text? Yes. My niece is 14 and she will not respond to a text, but if I Snapchat her, I get a response. We have to learn to adapt and we can't be like, well, that's hard, I don't get it. No, it's not. Find someone to sit down with you and they'll show you how to do it. Because we have got to learn. Another thing I've noticed is the spin studio that I teach at, our interns run the front desk. And when I come out, they're always on FaceTime with their friends. I was like, why on earth are you FaceTiming each other? Like, that's how we talk. I was like, where in the age have I been? That if you're in your 20s, you have to look at each other when you talk to each other. I was like, this is all coming back around. It went from we needed to be in person to a phone call to a text to now we're looking at each other again. So if you've got people in your 20s, do a Zoom with their prospects if they don't want to do a three-way call. If they're in their 20s, they're probably not going to answer the phone. I'm sorry, but they aren't. Unless you're putting money in their bank account, they're not going to pick up the phone for you. Or unless you pay their phone bill, right? They're not. So figure out what you can do. If you've got a prospect and you say, hey, I want to introduce you to Raylan. She's super amazing, hilarious. You have to hear what I'm doing. We're going to get on a Zoom. Here's the meeting ID code. If you're in, like, your maybe 50s even, you might be like, I have to do what? Her friends are going to be like, okay, cool. So is there an app? Okay, awesome. So I'll just hop on in a minute. So that sounds good? Okay, cool. She'll get on the dumb Zoom. Because they're in their 20s and they're like, whatever, sure. Give me a code. I'll download the app. We'll figure it out. The reason I say this is we have to be flexible as entrepreneurs and be ready to adapt. Even if you're like, I don't know what age I'm doing, let your 20-year-old leave the show and you just show up. If they know how to use the platform, let them leave the show and you just talk on it. But just be really open. If I'm overwhelming anyone in here and you're like, just talk and text, you're good. But otherwise, we have to be able to adapt. And I'm seeing these 20-year-olds. I was on an airplane and we're landing and this girl's FaceTiming her friend. I was like, wow, like, this is real. We've got to start learning to do Zooms for our prospects instead of just three-way calls. Four, which obviously you all are doing it for market parties, but our 20-year-olds like to look at their friends in the face again. Who knew? Oh, yeah. Well, my 14-year-old niece is like, FaceTimes when she's in the bathroom. I'm like, you and your friends are gross. She's like, well, we're just talking. I'm like, it's weird. Weirdos. So just be very open to the things out there. Like, the girl I'm talking to tonight, we're friends, I'm going to call her on the phone because that is what she's comfortable with. But, like, my niece, if I call her, she will not answer the phone. My son will not answer the phone. partake in beverages. And I have this picture saved in my phone, you guys. I don't actually go every time I do an RRP. But I took a picture of the wine aisle at our grocery store. And I'll be like, hey girl, just getting some wine for tonight. What kind do you like again? And I just have the phone picture in my phone. Like, I'm not at the grocery store. But I will send that because I generally have two reds and a white at my house at all times. And I'll be like, what kind do you drink again? And she'll be like, oh, you know, Pinot Grigio. I'm like, knew we were twins. Awesome. Bye, bye, whatever. So I'll say, I'll have your glass of wine poured. I don't care if you can only come for a half an hour. I need to see you this week. It has been a week. People want to feel special. If you make a Facebook invite for your RRP, no one is going to come to your house. It's okay if you've done it, but don't do it anymore. The purpose being, most of us don't see those invites or we get added to groups without our permission constantly. I'm added to so many groups on Facebook, I'm like, I don't know how I wear that many pairs of leggings. Like, I'm not sure. So, follow up and make it personal. It's been forever since we, like, the girl I did lunch with, I just said, oh, we have not talked in forever. I'd love to catch up. Do you want to grab lunch when you're in town? And so we just grab lunch. It is network marketing. We have to network with people. So just call them and say, it would not be the same without you. And if they're like, I know, but we have this and this and this, be like, oh, I get it, but I have chips and guac and margaritas, 30 minutes. Please come. They'll come and then they'll calm down once they get there and they'll relax and stay. So meet them where they are at. Think about how you would want to be approached. Because I would rather wash my cat than, I did not do that. I would rather wash my cat than go to parties sometimes. That screen does not match that one. It's giving you a heart attack. Okay, and then the same day, you want to remind them at about 12:30 if you're having a party, like remind them over their lunch hour so they have time to mentally prepare. Otherwise, at 5 o'clock, they'll decide they're not coming. Feel like I'm taking too long? Oh. Three strikes, I'm out, I know. Two down. Here, I have it on my phone too. I'll pull it up. Okay, it's new. We got this. Okay, I want everybody to stand up really quick. Humor me. Stand up. You have EHT. You're like young and agile people here. Okay, everybody stretch. Arms above your head. Just do it. I know what I'm doing here. Stretch it out. Do your neck. This will get your blood flowing, which is important because we need it to go to your brain. Okay, give yourself a shoulder roll. I would do jumping jacks in these heels too. I'm a little nervous. Shoulder roll. Turn to the person next to you and give them a big old smile. Aww, see? Give them some loving. Okay, have a seat. Let's pray through this. We just wanted to get our mojo moving. Guys, don't do what I'm doing. I'm not sure what it is.
I don't know what you did.
Remember that girl who never got to come back? She ruined everything. Dang it. I even had a smart board in my classroom. I know how to do this stuff, but I think I had my phone out. Oh, geez. Oh. I just got smart? Probably. Okay, cool. Well, he says it works, so I might have just messed it up. All right, so master the two-a-day system. You have in your notes your Fortune 14. So you did your two-a-day for 7 days, right? So step one is getting them some kind of third-party tool.
Yeah, take a picture.
If you don't know what to say to someone, get them products. Because if they fall in love with product, you don't have to worry about much of the rest. If their eyes look 10 years younger after eye serum, you're going to be like, girl, seriously? Have you sent this to any of your friends? You could have four customers. If you send them a video and they don't care about Nerium yet, guess what? They still don't care about Nerium. So figure out something. One thing I had to tell myself when I got started was not everyone is as interested in Nerium as you are, Kate Stevens. And, like, they don't care yet. Because my team will say, well, they're not replying to me. And I said, because they don't care yet. We need to add value. So a girl on my team, she's a doll. She just did a Zoom training for our team on Monday, and she talked about follow-ups. If you've got someone who wants product, and they won't order, and they won't order, and they won't order, and you're like, oh my gosh, message them about other things. How was your family trip? Oh my gosh, that picture's so cute. Talk to them about their real life. It's still a follow-up because they still associate you with Nerium, but it's not so pushy. So pique their interest, give them a tool. I almost always lead with product because I know that they're going to like it. I will say, though, when I started with Nerium, I ran like my hair was on fire. And I had a girl who I went to high school with, hardly knew her, sent her a message on Facebook, and I said, hey, have you ever heard of Nerium? And she goes, no, what is it? And I was like, cool, let me send you a video. Tell me what you think. Sent it to her. She's like, yeah, it was super interesting. I was like, awesome. She's a scientist. Like, what was I doing? She's a scientist. I was like, awesome. Well, what did you like best? And she's like, oh, I really like the science. I'm like, awesome. Can I call you quick? She said, okay. And she let me. And she signed up as a brand partner. Don't think so hard. That was the stupidest exposure ever. And it worked. And but overnight, she signed up her sister, and her sister signed up her best friend. If you screw it up, who cares? If you try something, it's better than not trying something. Right? Just do it. Especially if you don't know them very well, there's a lot less sting if they don't like it. So throw it out there, see what happens. I have also messaged people and said, hey, I have something to send you. What's your address? People will just give you their address. It's weird. Like, you can't have my phone number, but here's where I live. It's weird. But if you need to get exposures done and you feel like people are not listening to you, say, hey, what's your address? I have something I want to send you. They'll message it right back. I send either a 5-day trial of EHT with a magazine, or I send an eye patch or an eye serum, and I'll say the only catch is I would love for you to try it and then tell me what you think or take a picture. People like free stuff. They will send you their address. So if you feel ever stuck and you're having that, oh, I don't have anything in the funnel, send that message out to 5 people, and you will have 5 packages to send the next day. Some people I know just send magazines, but I feel like that's kind of cruddy. Like, hey, I have something for you. Here's a magazine. I mean, our magazines are amazing, but if you can give them an experience with a product, that's really a good way to do it. So that works. Follow up with a 3-way call. One thing I want to talk about with 3-way calls, and I know you're like, oh my gosh, it talks a lot. Yeah, I do. I was made this way, so sorry. I was also born 6 weeks early, so if that tells you my personality, that's how I am. So anyway, 3-way calls. One thing I think in this industry, not necessarily in Nerium, but in this industry, people look at 3-way calls like a close. I need to close my prospect, which in turn makes the field, makes all of you go, I don't want to put my friends on a 3-way call because I don't want them to be closed. Would you agree that many people feel that way? Now, I did get to a point in the area where I was like, yeah, you better close them on that call when I put them on with you. It depends on your perspective. But those of you who are struggling to get people on a 3-way call, I want you